Yes, good evening to all of you. So I think our expert has joined. So our today's expert is Dr. Bhagyashree Dekhle. She did her BSc from Maharashtra State Agriculture University, and then she went to Anand Agriculture University for her post-graduation in agriculture statistics. Then after a short while, she worked with India Meteorological Department in Fasal Scheme. Then she did her PhD from Bidhan Chandra Krishi Vishwavidyalaya in agriculture statistics. After that, she was with, for 2 years, she was at Indian Institute of Technology, Bhubaneswar. And she initiated the project with Dr. I forget the name of the scientist, sorry. She worked on extended range weather forecasting, and she gave a good products to India Meteorological Department. Right now, we are having those products with us. We are having a forecast, namely ERFS, which India Meteorological Department gives us after every three months. Then she worked at ICRISAT for 1 year. And in 2017, she joined as scientist at Department of Agriculture Statistics, Sher Kashmir University of Agriculture Science and Technology. So I invite her on behalf of organizing committee to deliver today's talk on regressions. So please, Dr. Bhagyashree, please proceed. You're not audible. You please unmute yourself.
Is my voice is audible?
You are audible, but very less. Your voice is not clear.
Now?
Yes, it's clear now.
Okay, thanks, Dr. Latif.
I forgot the name of that PI at IIT Bhubaneswar.
Dr. UC Mohanty.
Yeah.
Yeah, doctor, I was working with him for 2 years almost as a project scientist there in IIT Bhubaneswar.
Yeah, thank you. You please proceed, Dr. Bhagyashree, please.
Okay, so how we want hands-on practical for multiple regression?
Yes.
Okay, then little bit I'll give you introduction of regression analysis. Then we'll do it in Excel if you want in R also. I'll show
you
some
please,
commands.
You please start as per your convenience, please.
Okay, thanks. I want to share the screen, please. Allow me to share the screen.
Please share it. It's allowed.
Okay, good evening, everyone. Myself, Dr. Bhagyashree Dekhle. I'm assistant professor in the Division of Agriculture Statistics, First Kashmir. Today, I will give you some highlights on the regression modeling. As most of the participants are from agriculture background.
Mostly from agriculture background, agrometeorology and agriculture.
Okay.
One or two are from botany.
Okay, no problem. So considering most of the students from agriculture background, you might have studied in your PG course, most of the participants, let's start 511 course in which you have gone through the regression analysis. Let us revise some points of the regression analysis today. So as we all know, the statistician deals with the data. We deals with the data and we give some outputs from the data. So statistics is nothing but dealing with the data and giving the meaningful information out of the data. So there are many ways we give the meaningful information. So one of the way that like suppose I have 100 students in a class, and if I'm counting the height of the students and measuring the height, and I will say the average height of the students in a class is 5.5 feet. So it means that I'm representing the whole data in one figure. So that kind of analysis is a measures of central tendency, which is a univariate kind of analysis, where we can analyze some samples or a population and give some interpretation out of it. But sometimes we are having the two or more samples, two or more population. That time we studied some analysis, we study some relationship between the two or more variables. So that time we come into terms like correlation and regression. So as you all know, might be knowing, the correlation is nothing but the finding out the linear relationship between the two variables, two or more variables. So if the two or more variables, like suppose yield and rainfall, these are the two variables. So how the yield is, these two factors are, two variables are related or not. So to find out, we go for the correlation analysis and we'll get some output out of that. So if the two variables are correlated, then next question comes, which variable, how much, because of change in the rainfall, is the yield is changing? And if it is changing, how much it is changed because of change in the rainfall? Suppose the rainfall is changed by the 10 mm, how much yield is changing? So that time the term comes regression. So now the technique by which we can analyze the relationship among the correlated variables is known as the regression analysis. Sir Francis Galton gives the term regression analysis. So nothing but regression analysis is the functional relationship of one or more variables, that is the dependent variable, on one or more independent variables. Independent variables in the regression analysis, also known as explanatory variables, which explains the variation in the dependent variable. Suppose independent variables in agriculture term, you can take a dependent variable yield, and independent variable like fertilizer, number of tillers, seed rate, or any technological factors you can consider. So these variables explains the variation in the yield. So these are known as explanatory variables, and yield is your dependent variable. So here we can see the functional relationship of the regression is given by y of functional of function of xi. So I can be one variable or two or more variables. So this functional relationship is kind of the deterministic relationship, where error term is not counting. So suppose if I am taking any physics laws, any object I am taking, and if I am throwing through to a ground, so it will go by velocity of 9.8 meter per second square. So that will be constant everywhere. If there is no in between, there is nothing is there. This law is constant, so there is no error terms. But in agriculture or in other fields, our variables like the height and weight, number of tillers, so they follow some probability distribution. Hence, the error terms comes. So in statistical regression, our dependent variable, our functional relationship changes considering the dependent variable and the error term. So here in statistical regression, the dependent variable is the function of one or more independent variable and the error term, which can be represented in the form of y is a function of xi, that is any independent of variables, and error associated with mu I. So this is some small example of the regression analysis, what we can do from the regression. Suppose I want to know, I want to predict the yield of a yield of any crop, then what are the factors are affecting on it? So there are some weather factors are there, some technological factors are there. So whether it comes the temperature, humidity, rainfall, sunshine, wind speed, soil temperature. So in technological factor, there are many factors are there, that different kinds of varieties, fertilizer dose is changing, nutrient management practices, insecticide, etc. This comes under the technology. If I will consider both of the variables and predict the yield, then it is the multiple linear regression equation. So regression analysis is mostly a prediction kind of technique. So we can use to predict it is a prediction technique which we use for the prediction purpose. So now if we can see the regression analysis, there are two kinds of regressions. One is the simple linear regression and one is the non-linear regression. In simple linear regression, as this graph indicates, that there is a linear relationship between the two variables. We can say that change in the one unit in the one independent value, there will be change in a same way to a dependent variable, or linearly it will change to a dependent variable. But in non-linear regression, by changing the independent value by one unit, it may not be a product of one unit, it can change non-linearly. There will not be a straight line. So here you can say this is a non-linear regression, this is a linear regression. So both the regressions are of two types, that is the simple linear regression or multiple linear regression. If we consider only one independent variable, that is y is equal to bx, where x is only one independent variable, then this is a simple linear regression equation where x is the independent variable and y is the dependent variable. So this is the basic form of regression equation where we say y is the dependent variable, x is my independent variable. It explains the variation in the yield. Hence, it is also known as explanatory variable. A and B are the regression coefficient. A is the regression constant, B is the regression coefficient. And as in statistics, error term is involved, so it is error is there. In multiple regression equation, we are having the multiple independent variable and only one dependent variable. So that's why here our equation form we changing from y is equal to a plus b1x1 plus b2x2 plus e. So here x1 and x2 are the two independent variables. Here, for example, you can take the height of the student and suppose weight is dependent variable, height of the student and age. These two factors can be a independent variable. So in same way, nonlinear regression equation is also two types. Simple linear nonlinear regression equation, multiple nonlinear regression equation. This I have to change. So in nonlinear regression equation, there are two types. One is nonlinear in the variable. If you see here variable, it is in the square root terms. In multiple linear regression, nonlinear regression, one variable is in the nonlinear form, one is in the linear form. So this is the multiple nonlinear regression equation. So here we will go for only a linear regression analysis. We'll study linear regression analysis only. So what are the basic assumptions of the multiple linear regression? We will not go for the simple linear regression. We will study, we will go for the multiple linear regression equation. So first assumption that there must be a linear relationship between the independent and outcome variable, that is dependent variable. So in linear relation regression, we should have the linear relationship. Change in one variable, it will be a unit change in the other variable, means there should be a linear relationship. So how we can get that? Using the scatter plot, we can identify whether the relationship between the two variable is linear or curvilinear. The second assumption is the normality. So as we know that our variables follows the different probability distribution. So normal distribution, generally our continuous variables follows the normal distribution. Hence regression assumes that the residuals from the regression analysis follows are normally distributed. So if your variables are normally distributed, then you can use multiple linear regression equation. So there should not be any multicollinearity between the independent variables. Suppose you are taking two or three variables like the minimum temperature, maximum temperature, rainfall. So these are also interrelated with each other. So there should not be the correlation between the independent variable. So before going the analysis, you have to check, is there multicollinearity in the data or not? So if they are not multicollinear, then you can use in the multiple regression. So multiple regression assumes that the independent variables are not highly correlated with each other. So this can be tested using the variance inflation factor. This assumption can be tested. So next assumption that homoscedasticity. So this assumption states that that error variance is constant over the population. Means whatever the samples you have taken, the error variance do not change from one variable to other variable. So this assumption states that the variance of the error terms are similar across the values of the independent variable. The next assumption is the independent of the errors. So residuals should be independent or uncorrelated. So these are some assumptions of the multiple linear regression. So how, as we know that, here we can see that this is our equation. Y is equal to A plus B1X1 plus B2X2 plus E. So as we are having the independent set of data, suppose I am having the temperature data and the rainfall data and yield data I am having, but I don't have the values of A, B, B1 and B2. So if I will get the values of A, B1 and B2, then and then only I can predict the Y. So in the regression equation, we have to estimate the values of A, B1 and B2. So estimation of multiple linear regression is done by using the ordinary least square method with the optimizing, means with the criteria that the error term between the observed variable and the predicted variable should be the minimum. So we'll not go deep in the what is the least square criteria. Just I will give you that this is the we are taking the expected values of the both the side, that is expected value, that is predicted values of y, giving beta naught plus beta 1 x1 beta 2 x2 plus beta p xp plus error terms. These are my multiple linear regression equation. So I want to estimate the values of beta naught, beta 1, beta 2 and beta p. So this is my sample data will be there. So y is my dependent variable, x1 to xp are the independent variables, and then using some different softwares you can do the multiple linear regression, and you can estimate the values of y, that is the predicted values of y, then beta naught, beta 1, beta 2, beta p. These you can estimate using the least square method, using any software, and then these estimated values are the values gives the estimates of the beta naught, beta 1, beta 2 and beta p. So in regression, the main thing we have to find out the values of beta naught, beta 1, beta 2 and beta p. That is the values of regression constant and the regression coefficient with least square method of estimation. I hope everyone is on my line. I don't know how everything is going because this is virtual seminar and no, I can't get the from the audience. I can't hear from the audience. So once you fit the regression equation, then you have to see some of the things, that is the F test. Whenever you will feel, you will go for the regression, you will get some outputs, any software, if you go for the analysis or by hands, if you are doing the least square criteria, then you have to see the F test. F test is nothing but the ANOVA test, where we are dividing the total variation. Suppose I'm taking the yield, total variation in yield is due to, suppose I have the yield and the temperature as an independent variable. So total variation in the yield is due to how much, due to the temperature. So I'm dividing my whole ANOVA into two parts. That is the variation in the yield may be due to the temperature and may be due to the error term. Means the factors I'm not considering in my equation. So that ANOVA can be tested using the F test of significance. So F test is used to determine whether a significant relationship exists between the dependent variable and the set of all independent variables. The F test is referred to as a test of overall significance. Then once your regression equation is significant, suppose F test is coming significant, then you have to see that, suppose in the multiple regression, you have two factors. You are taking temperature also, you are taking rainfall also. So your whole ANOVA is getting divided into the variation due to the temperature, second the variation due to the rainfall, and then error terms. Now you have to see that, is the temperature is also really affecting, or is your rainfall is really affecting. For that purpose you have to go for the t-test. Likewise, if you see here, this is your regression. If your F test is coming significant, it means your whole regression is coming significant. But you have to find out whether in multiple regression, mostly this problem comes, whether this individual factor X1 and X2 is really affecting or not. So this can be tested, that is the testing of the significance of the regression coefficient, that is beta 1 and beta 2, using the t-test. So if F test shows an overall significant, then T test is used to determine whether the each individual independent variable is significant or not. A separate T test is conducted for each of the independent variable in the model. So this is a small example, and afterward we will go for the practical. A software firm collected the data of the sample of 20 computer programmers. A suggestion was made that the regression analysis could be used to determine if the salary was related to the years of experience and the scores on the firm's programmer aptitude test. So here the year of experience is given, the score of the aptitude is there, and salary is there. So is the salary, is salary, obviously salary is dependent on the years of experience and how much is the IQ value of the that programmer. So here the data is given, like the experience. Suppose first there was a first variable, first parameter is here. That is first case is there 4 years of experience having the aptitude test of 78 with the salary of 24. Salary, I think so in US dollar, $1,000. So likewise, I have 20 individuals, their salary and score is given. Suppose we believe that the salary Y is related to the years of experience, that is X1, and X2 is the score of the aptitude test. So I'm saying the salary is dependent on the years of experience and score of the aptitude test. So this is my regression. So here, this is my the basic data. I will use any software package to estimate the values of beta naught, beta 1, beta 2, R square, etc. So this can be done using the least square method of estimation. So after that, I will get some outputs. This is one of the output from that one. Here I will get the intercept. That is my regression constant value. Then experience. This is my experience, that is X1 variable. And test score was my X2 variable. And their coefficients are there. So for intercept, that is A value is here, beta 1 value is here, beta 2 value is here. So as I told you earlier, that t-test is used to test whether the individual variable is significant or not. So here I can see that I want to see the individually experience is significantly affecting the salary and test score is independently affecting the salary. So with this, we can check. I will explain in the practical what we are doing online, how we can test it. This is just an example. So here we can see that for change, as the experience is 1.4 years, as the experience changes from 1.4 years to next, the salary is changing. Then for the aptitude, if the aptitude score is changed with the unit value of 0.251. So interpreting the coefficients. So beta 1 value is the 1.40 and beta 2 value is 0.251, which we are getting here, 1.40 and 0.25. So what it says? The salary is expected to increase by US dollar 1,404 for each additional years of experience. Means as experience changes for 4 to 5 years, that is 1 year of changing, the salary changes by 1,404 US dollars. Same way, as salary is expected to increase by the US dollars of 251 for each additional point score of the programmer's aptitude test. I hope everyone is getting this point of the interpreting the coefficient. So when we does the regression analysis, at that time we are dividing our total sum of squares, means total variation, into two parts in ANOVA, like the due to the regression and due to the error term. Means here both due to the aptitude and due to the experience, what is the change in the average salary and what is the error term. So here we can get, this is the ANOVA part is there. So due to the my two factors, how much variation in the out of total variation of the 599, my two variables are explaining around 500 sum of squares and error term is only 99. So this is one of the ANOVA. Here F test is there, here we from which we can test the whether the regression is significant or not. So generally in regression analysis we see is the R square value, that is the sum of squares of regression divided by total sum of squares of a total sum of square. Here the value is 500 divided by 599. So our R square is 0.83. So R square value, this is a multiple coefficient of determination. It is one of the parameter from which we can get our regression analysis good or not. So if its value is ranges between 0 to 1, closer to 1 value gives that the our regression is the giving the better values. Our regression analysis is good. So adjusted multiple coefficient of determination, that is the R square adjusted. Suppose we are having the linear regression, multiple linear regression equation have one disadvantage that if we increase the number of variables like the temperature, rainfall, humidity, RH1, RH2, if you are taking the 4 variables, R square will be suppose 0.8. If you increase the 2 more variables, then also R square will increase because of increasing the adding of the variables in the equation. That's why that time you have to see the adjusted R square value. The formula for this is given here. N is the total number of variables and P is the number of variables, total number of cases, and P is the number of variables we have considered. Here 20 were the cases and P are the only two independent variables are there. So these are two. So this value is coming same around 0.81. So here if you see it is 0.83, but adjusted R square is saying 0.81. So generally we consider adjusted R square. So this is my example data which we will do in the Excel. The following data gives the yield along with the number of hills per square meter, X1, that is my X1 variable, number of effective tillers, X2, and panicle length. Now I want to find out the regression of the yield on with these variables. So this data will take in Excel and will do a regression analysis. So this is my same data set is there, where the I have 20 observations on the yield and these are my independent variable, that number of hills per meter square, effective tillers, panicle length. So everyone has to go, first of all you have to see whether in the data here data analysis tool pack is there or not. In Excel you need this data analysis tool pack. If it is not there, you have to go in this menu, Excel options, then go in add-ins. You have to see whether Excel add-ins, go click on the analysis tool pack, analysis tool pack VBA, click OK. Then it will configure your this Microsoft Excel again, and then you will get this data analysis tool pack here. So for running most of the statistical, basic statistical analysis, you need this data analysis tool pack. So if you are here, you can see ANOVA of the single factor, two factor without replication, correlation, you can do some descriptive statistics you can do. So here
excuse me, Vakshri, you need to change, I think you need to change the screen. There will be multiple screens open in your laptop.
Okay.
You need to change the screen because you are working on Excel now, na?
Ha, yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. So how I have to change here? Okay.
Yeah. You go to the
I got it, sir. Here I have to change. Yes. Now I'm sharing the same screen.
Yeah. It's okay now.
Okay. Sorry, huh? So this is my Excel data where you can see the 20 observations of yield, number of hills per meter square, effective tillers, and panicle length. So here, any statistical analysis we have to do, here our is the data analysis tool pack is there. So if it is not there in any one Excel, then you have to go here, click here, start menu option, then go to Excel options, add-ins, then go Excel add-ins, go. Here there are two options you have to click, analysis tool pack and analysis tool pack VBA, click OK. So it will automatically gives you data analysis tool pack in the data menu. So if you see here are basic statistical analysis you can do from here, that is ANOVA single factor, two factor with replication, correlation is there, descriptive statistics, etc. is there. So here if you click, here is the regression, click OK. So this window will come. So what it says input Y range, input X range. So Y is my dependent variable, so I have to select this Y. I have selected this input X range, I have to give all of them 3. So here B to D from 1 to 21. Yes, I have labels, whatever my variables are there for them, title is there, headers is there. So I'm clicking labels. If you don't have labels, then unclick this this menu. So then confidence level, I need 95% of confidence level. Constant is 0. If you click on this, then you will not get the regression constant. A, Y is equal to BX. You will get the relationship Y is equal to BX. But I want A in my regression equation. So you can click the output option where you want the output. I want output in the same Excel sheet. So I am clicking here. Just I am getting this output. Or you can say that new worksheet, it will give you another worksheet of this same Excel. on new workbook, new Excel file will be open. So here you, what you want, residuals you want, standardized residuals you want, residual plot you want, etc. I just want a residual. How much error is there in my data? Click OK. So this will give you a regression output. So now here we can see. So this is my summary output. If you can see, this is the multiple R regression statistic. This is nothing but the correlation. Correlation between the yield and these all three independent variable, it is around 0.93. R square is there, that is 0.86. Means R square range is 0 to 1. Near to 1 is a good regression. So my all three variables are really affecting on the yield with 86% of variation. 86% of the variation in the yield data is due to only three factors. Remaining 14% may be due to the other factors which I have not considered here, or this is the error term you can see. Then adjusted R square is 0.83. Standard error, the error standard error is just like the standard deviation of whole divided by the number of observations. My number of observations are 20. So here is the ANOVA, what we are seeing in the regression. So here we have to see the F test, the significance of the F test. Here if we see the significance of F test, that is this value is 0.000 number of zeros, 3 something value is like that. So it should be less than 0.05. If it is less than 0.05, it means that at 5% level of significance, my regression is significant. Whatever the variables I have considered in the regression that are really affecting the yield. Now next question comes, is all the variables are affecting the yield, or only out of three only two are affecting, or out of three all are affecting, or out of three only one is affecting? That you have to see. So now below, if you can see here, this is my one table is coming, that is intercept, yield per meter square. These are my three independent variables are there. This is my regression coefficient. These values are important. This is your value of A. So this is value of your A. This is your beta 1 regression coefficient. This is your beta 2 value. And this is your beta 3 value. As I have three variables, I will get the three regression coefficient and one regression constant. The error associated with this coefficient is given in this. And t statistics, that is the, I have already told that using the t test, we can test each individual variable is affecting or not. So here the t value is there, and its p value you have to check. If the value is less than 0.05 p value, that means every variable is affecting the regression. So here you can see this is 9.49 into e raised to minus 10. So it will be 0.009 times, then 9. So it is affecting. All three are knee. Then hill per meter square is affecting, but these two are non-significant. These values are more than 0.05. So you can omit these variables and consider only these two are, this hill per meter square is affecting. If you consider without significance, then all of them are giving, explaining the 0.86% of the variation, but these two are non-significantly affecting the yield. So this is your predicted values of the yield. So this was your observed values. Here you can see this was your observed value of the yield, and this is a predicted using the regression. This is your regression. So these are your two values, observed and predicted, and this is the error associated with each value. So if you take the difference of the two, you will get the same value. So this is your basics of the regression analysis. One more point I can tell. So this you can do in Excel. Always remember the number of cases. Whatever, suppose I am having three independent variables, then number of cases for each should be five times more than that. suppose I am having 3 independent variables, my number of cases should be more than 15. If it is less than 15, your error degrees of freedom will be less. So that time it will not give you the correct analysis. So always remember, your number of cases in multiple linear regression should be 5 times than your independent variables. So shall I show in this one in R? Excuse me, sir.
Before proceeding, there is one query has been raised by Dr. S. Nadav regarding. Okay. I need to install data set in Excel. Please tell me how to install that.
Can data you repeat set. That?
Data set. Not actually, he's not asking for data set. Actually, he is asking for tool.
Okay, this is the tool. Data analysis tool pack. This is your tool pack. Is there? If it is not there, in most of the cases, it will not be there. So if you are using first time, click on this option, then go to Excel options. Menu option, then go to Excel options. In that one, add-ins is there. You have to click here. Below that, in the manage option, Excel add-ins is there. Go and click on these two packs. Data analysis tool pack, data analysis tool pack, VBA. Click OK. So after refreshing, again close the Excel and open it. You will get this data analysis tool pack in the data menu. If you click on the data menu, you will get data analysis tool pack.
Dr. Nataf, did you got it?
Yes, sir. I got it, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Proceed, Dr. Bashir. Proceed, please.
Okay. I will show in R also. Most of the students are using the R. This is the basic Excel. You can have anyone.
You unmute, Bakshiri, you unmute yourself.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is my data set I'm using for R. Now I have to change my screen. I'm just copying first this data set. To see screen now. From where I will
go to share screen, then change that. If you have opened R there,
I have opened, just I'm checking.
Go to share screen.
Okay, so this is my R studio. Is there already? I am having these commands. So this is my commands. That is read.table is the command where you can read the Excel files from any Excel files. So here read.table, whatever in my clipboard, that is copy command is there, you will read it. And giving header is equal to true, which means that whatever the headers are there, labels are there, that will be that it will take. So already I have copied the data from the Excel. So it is giving blue line here. Then the next command in the R is fit is there. LM is used to giving the linear, this multiple linear regression. LM, Y is equal to hill plus tillers plus panicles. And data set is nothing but my rice data set. From the rice data set, you have to fit the regression. Y is equal to hill plus tiller plus panicle. 3 independent variables affecting the yield. And the function is LM. Run, then give the summary of the fit, whatever the LM in LM function, whatever the summary is there, that we will get. So here you can see some summary is there. So this is my summary fit. I am getting the yield is dependent on the hill, tiller and panicles. So whatever the values of residuals, whatever error terms are there, their values are minimum, maximum values are given and median values are given. Whatever we got in Excel also, residual values. Then this is the coefficient. The whatever we got the coefficients in R, the same we will get here. Intercept values, these are the beta in A value coefficient. Hill beta 1 value is there. Tiller beta 2 value is there. Panicle, this value is there. So out of which first two are highly significant. there we are getting the double triple star. So this means they are significantly affecting. As we seen in Excel also, these two are non-significantly affecting. We are not getting any significant value. Here you can say the multiple R value is given, adjusted R square value is given, then F statistic value is given, that is 34.19. So here P value is given whether your regression is significant or not, 3.44. So after that, I am giving one command, that is the plotting. For plotting, there are four plots are coming in the regression equation. So PAR, MF, rho is there. So I am running this command and plot fit. Okay. So these are four plots are coming. So four plots are residual versus fitted, normal QQ plot, scale location plot, and residual versus leverage plot. So residual versus fitted plot is giving your whether the regression equation is linear or not. If your all the points are around this.
Excuse me, Dr. Bagshiri, excuse me. Participants are asking, will you please start it again? What are the commands we are using?
No problem, sir. Rise, giving read.table. In bracket, you have to give the clipboard command. Whatever in your clipboard, whatever I'm copying, I'm giving in Excel, Control C. So whatever in my clipboard is there, you read the command. So this is the simple command, is read.table clipboard header is equal to true. So then the LM command is used for the fitting the regression equation. So I am saying, computer, that is the fit LM yield epsilon yield is a dependent variable, fit from Hill, Taylor and Panicle. And consider my data is rice. Here, because I am defining rice is my data set. Then summary fit is option is there. Then this is plotting option is there. And these are the commands. If you want, I will share the same commands to sir. He will share you all through your mails or anything. The same PPT and other things I will share to all of you. So you all can go through the same. So plot fit, you have to give the command here. I'm getting all four plots. These are my four plots are there. So first plot is residual versus fitted, normal QQ plot, scale location, residual versus leverage. So residual versus fitted, it gives the whether your regression is linear or not, whatever your residual values, and these are your fitted values. If your all the values are lying between this, means both the sides of this red line, then you can say that your regression is linear. Then normal QQ plot, it gives your assumption of the residuals, that residual should be normally distributed. If your points are, whatever the points are there, data points, if you are, they are lying nearly to this straight line, then you can say your data set is, means residuals are normally distributed. Then scale location plot, it is for the your next assumption of the heteroscedasticity. That means if your all the values of the residuals are lying equally to these points, means all the points are there, residual points are lying equally to your values, it means this red line, then you can say that this is your there is homoscedasticity in the data, no heteroscedasticity. Then next is the residual versus leverage. So here you see that whether any outlier is there in your data set, that you can get from this data set. So if any point lying to a distance to this red line, then that point can be considered as an outlier. Then you have to replace it by any mean or median value and again do the analysis to get your data is significant. Any one value or two values you can change in your data sets. So this is basics of the regression, how to fit the multiple regression in R and Excel. Sir, I am done with this. Anything if you want, this is the basic of this.
Okay, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for delivering such a nice lecture. First of all, showing all the PPTs, regression modeling and all, what is regression modeling, then doing a practical exercise on regression modeling using Excel, then using R also. most of the participants, I think they are asking. I will share with them the PPT, the sheets which you will share with me. I will share with them. Now, participants are requested to unmute. Any question, participants?
Madam. Hello.
Yes, sir.
What you told about the degrees of freedom?
Means degrees of freedom, our basic idea should be that the degrees of freedom should be more than 10 or 12. If your number of variables, suppose you are having the 20 variables, and if you are taking 20 variables, means like 20 observations in your data sets.
Okay.
Okay. And if your number of parameters are like 8 or 10.
Yeah.
Okay, okay, like suppose you are taking temperature, maximum temperature, minimum temperature, technology, then insecticide applied, any other factors if you are considering, suppose you are having 10 independent variables and 20 cases are there. That time your regression will not run.
What should be minimum?
Minimum value should be more than 10. So it will come when your data set should have 4 to 5 independent variables. If you are having 20 observations, means 5 times, it should be a 5 times.
Of which 5 times?
5 times of your cases. Suppose you are having 20 observations and suppose 5 independent variables are there. So how much it will be? 5 4s are 20. Suppose parameters are there, 5 independent parameters are there. Suppose maximum temperature is there, minimum temperature is there, rainfall is there, and 2 more parameters are there. And your number of cases should be more than 20. At least 5 times it should be. It should be like 25 cases should be there. Now here if you see, I have 20 observations and 3 hills are there.
Yeah.
Huh? Then you see in the Excel file, I'll show you the Excel file. In Excel
and what about if that is more than 5?
More than 5, then it should be more than 5 times. I'm saying if you are having independent variable 10, then number of cases should be 50. Likewise. Okay. It's for getting your results in a better way.
Okay.
Okay. If
it is below 20, then?
Suppose if you are having 10 parameters, then regression will not run, sir. It will I'm sharing the Excel file.
Please.
I'm sharing the Excel file. Now, how many number of observations are there? 20. 20 and number of observations here? So if you see, the degrees of freedom is here 19.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So 3 is the due to the regression. As I'm having 3 independent variable, 3 is there. You are having 10 independent parameters. That time your total will be 9. Suppose I am having 10 independent parameters, 20 cases. Okay. My cases are, how many cases are there? 20. And 20 are my independent parameters.
Yeah.
Got it? So first of all, 20 minus 10 will be error degrees of freedom. That is 10 degrees of freedom due to the regression.
Yeah.
Okay. So 19 will be the due to the total degrees of freedom. 20 minus 1. Here you can see 20 minus 1. 19 will be the total degrees of freedom. If you minus this, it will be 9 degrees of freedom to your error term at that time. If you take 10 regression variables, 10 independent variables for the 20 number of cases, then your degrees of freedom will be the 9. Generally in statistics, we say that it should be more than 10. Your significance will be affected. Your significance value will be affected. For that purpose, you should take at least 5 times.
Same is the case with when we do regressive experiments, we need error degree of freedom should be more than 11.
It's more than 10 at least. 10 is the minimum.
Yeah, whether you will increase their application, whether you increase the treatment, minimum error degree of freedom should be more than 10.
Yes, sir.
You got your queries?
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Any other query?
Ma'am, can you please once explain the equation, how to make the equation? That regression equation.
Okay, see, here is my 3 points are there. I will make highlight it with the yellow. So this is my the regression coefficient is there. This is my intercept value. So how I will make y is equal to, first, what is the regression equation? First, we will write here. Y is equal to a plus b1 x1 plus b2 x2 plus b3 x3 plus error term is there. This is my multiple linear regression. So now I have to make the equation here. So y is equal to, so intercept value is your regression constant, that is a value. So it will be 132.54 plus 4.23 b1. You consider x1 is your heel per meter square, plus 2.42 x2. Then next variable is having minus sign.
Minus.
Huh? That's why I'm giving minus sign 1.07 x3. Mm-hmm. So this is my regression equation. So always you need to concentrate on this point, coefficient value, this p value, and this f value, significance, and r square and adjusted r square. These values you have to always see in any regression.
Okay. Ma'am, and what about this error term E?
Residuals. Na? You can see here, E is there. We generally do not mention here average error, but here is your error is there associated with each of your cases.
So here you can
mention in equation like E, like this.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
So any other queries from participants?
Hello. Another query is from Dr. Asin Nadaf. R Studio software and please guide initial steps and methods of learning the software. It's a very big procedure to learn the R Studio software.
There should be one separate lecture
for dev, and then we have to leave the DSAT aside and take the lectures on R only.
He can get from internet search. He can get every idea.
Okay. Thank you, madam. Thank you, sir.
Another question: R square software and R. What is the difference?
Same software. R studio is better than R. Means like old Android phone means old phone and Android phone. So it is like that. R and R studio is the same software.
Updated version
means it is the easygoing version. You can opt old, you can use the old phone also, now new phone also. So likewise, you can use the basic R also on in R studio. You will get the easiest option to choose.
Yeah, in 2003 I used the R for mapping person, plotting the map. It was very difficult task in that time, and presently now it has become very easy to use the R software. Whosoever is interested in learning R software. And one more question, madam, you please this Excel sheet you will share with me so that I can share with you.
Yes sir, I will share this Excel sheet, PPT, and R commands also.
Also, we have a recording. We are going on. Recordings will be also shared with the participants. Any other question? How to omit non-significant variables?
So here you can, if you see this, this is non-significantly affecting, then I will delete this variable. Suppose I'm taking all three, cut, copy, pasting it here. So I will delete this variable. And again, I will do the regression analysis. So same way I have to do, only I have to take the two independent variable here now.
Okay, the variable which is showing us now, sir, we can skip that variable.
We can skip that one. Huh? We can skip. Now here I'm getting 3. Then this is also non-significantly affecting. I will omit that too. And here only hill per meter square is affecting, giving 85% of variation. I think so 85 same will be there. It will affect the hill per meter square is significantly affecting the yield. Then these two parameters.
That means our scan value is, and that means 85% is dependent, yield is dependent, 85% is affected through the hills per meter square.
And for this data set, for this data set,
for this, for this data set, and rest be the other parameters.
Yeah, yeah.
15% of the other parameters. Yeah. Any other question? Any other question from participants? Participants can unmute themselves. I opened all.
No, sir. No question.
Clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Dr. Latif is there?
Yes.
Dr. Latif, thanks Dr. Bagshiri for giving such a nice lecture, such a nice, I think I have myself learned, first of all, I have myself learned the regression because I am doing simulation modeling only. I'm not using the statistical tactics and all that. Recently, I attended a meeting on our software using the techniques of regression analysis and all that. Today I saw how to do the regression analysis using these Excel sheets, simple Excel sheets. Thanks a lot. Latif, you proceed, please. Dr. Latif?
Okay, thank you.
Your voice is not clear. Yeah, it's okay now.
Thank you very much, Dr. Bagishri, for this comprehensive lecture. It was very nice. I hope participants have learned a lot. This was the first step before they will start their hands-on practical for DSAT.
Yes.
I know it was very tough for you to arrange this lecture in a short duration of time. I want to say to participants that Dr. Bagishri is a newly mother, and it was really tough for her to get this 1 hour for us. So we are very fortunate enough that she arranged this 1 hour for us. Thank you very much. Thank you on behalf of the organizing committee.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for giving me opportunity. I'm really thankful to coordinator.
Thanks for such a nice lecture.
Thank you, sir, for giving me opportunity, and I'm also glad to have interact with the participants. It's a really nice platform, so we can get through virtual mode. I'm on my leave, still I can do something like this. It's really nice.
Actually, why I asked you to deliver it today, regression modeling, because from tomorrow onwards, it will be totally DSAT.
Yes, I can understand.
Once we'll start DSAT running programs, we cannot, in between, we cannot call for a regression analysis and all that. Because basically, whatever the models use, they use all these regression analysis and all for the,
the
models, development models. So I'm very, very thankful that you, in the short span of time, you were asked to deliver, and you delivered it nicely. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving me opportunity. It was nice.
Thank you. Thank you, Bagishri. Thank you.
Okay, bye. Thank you, Latif, Dr. Latif. Thank you, Bilal, sir.
Bye.
Thanks, sir. Participants, please unmute all participants. And please open your video. Also have a group photograph. Open your videos all. Bhakti, please bear with us for a few minutes.
No problem, sir.
Please open your videos, all open your videos. Whosoever is there. thanks a lot, Vakshi. Thanks a lot.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Will remain here. Yeah, but Dr. Vikas, your query is clear?
What, sir?
You have raised your hand. Any query?
No. That time I have raised, sir.
Okay. But that's clear, na? Okay. All the participants have downloaded this DSAT on your laptops or desktops.
Anyone? No, sir. Still not.
No, sir. Still message is coming that you have to wait for several days.
No. I yesterday asked from my other desktop and they sent me the link today. It don't take...
No, sir. Yet not received, sir.
How many people?
After several days, after confirmation.
Next day
it will come.
Yet not next successfully installed, sir.
If you are email, you are given, you might be having the wrong email ID. Otherwise, it takes only 24 next day. You will get the link to download the DSAT. It's like that.
Next day, it is coming.
We will wait till tomorrow, sir.
Actually, I have submitted the email ID and they are saying that you have to wait. And I have confirmed it. I have got a successful confirmation mail back.
Yeah, successful confirmation. Yes. After that, you will get another email in which...
Sir, that is what I am saying. The another email I have not received yet, sir.
I have received, sir.
Mustafa, sir, that you will receive by today.
Tomorrow you can receive.
Tomorrow you will receive it, and download it, and just install in your laptops.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
If any of the participants have earlier versions of DSAT, for example, 4.5, 4.6, we have no problem with that also. There is it hardly matters. Everything is same. Whether it's 4.5, 4.6, 4.7, some things they have changed in the exam. Crops may have, they have been added in 4.7, 4.7.5. Now, in the next year, Dr. Jared was telling that we are releasing 4.8 also. Maybe by adding some more crops in it. Tomorrow, all the participants are requested that tomorrow is the lecture of Dr. Sumira Qayyum. Dr. Sumira Qayyum at 4 p.m. exactly, because she will give the lecture from the office. She's very much busy as she's a nodal officer of ICR of our campus. And besides that, she is in charge, head of agri-med section, looking after GKM as a puzzle scheme. We will have what are the minimum data set requirements of DSAT? What are the minimum data sets we are required to run the DSAT program actually? All the participants are satisfied with the lecture that she'll start at 4 p.m. You can join that lecture with on your phone also. After that, once we start running DSAT program, then you have to use your laptops also along with us. Is it okay for you?
Okay, sir.
Any other query? All the recordings we are doing here, all the sessions are recorded here. That also will be shared with you. Apart from that, we are preparing a sort of manual, practical manual on DSAT, starting from weather, soil, how to input the weather data sets, how to make the weather data sets, how to input the soil data sets, then how to make the crop management file, then how to run the program, how to generate the results, how to build the graph. Those all sessions will be recorded and will be shared with you. And once you feel any
difficulty in it, you can open that video. You can look again how they have done this, how they have, what is the procedure actually, uploading of weather file of for DSAT file, crop management file, and how they generate the results. Then validation of our results with the observed data from the fields. That's a very important thing. Also, that apart from that, sensitivity analysis will be also a class on how to carry out a sensitivity analysis in DSAT, right? Because if Dr. Geeta Lakshmi yesterday was telling that agronomy, simple agronomy will not work now. Simple agronomy will not work now. But we have to change our mindsets. We have to change our mindset. Come out of these cocoons, working on rate and date. That rate and date will not work now. Until and unless you will have those soft skills in your hands, then only you can proceed and you can prosper in your life. That's all what I can say. Shiraz, Dr. Shiraz.
Yes, Dr. Bilal.
Anything to discuss here?
Nothing. It was nice, informative lecture delivered by Dr. Bhagyashree and nicely organized. So far, the lectures are concerned. So I'm expecting more hands-on lectures will come and every participants will be benefited. And more importantly, for the download of the DSAT software, like you advised them, so they have to be ready with this. So yeah, it's nicely done. Thank you.
Already I have shared them the how to go to Google, how to open them, how to go to Google and then search for the DSAT. Then you just get the information of our email ID and for which purpose you are using 5 points. You can put research, teaching, climate change, research, and you can put 5 points in that. Yep. And after that, next, once the mail will be sent to them, they will set as mail have been successfully received. And the next day, your next mail will be received by you in which you will get a link to download DSAT. If I will share my link with you, that will not work. My link, I can share my link which I have received for downloading. That will not work on your desktops. I can share that, but that will not work. It is better to be, you will be also enlisted in, you will be also listed in DSAT list where your name will be there also. Whatever the updation regarding the DSAT will be there, you will be informed via mails also. You'll be updated regularly. Regarding any crop, if any crop has been included, any other crop has been included, our version have been changed from 4.8. Now, next year, we'll get 4.8. After that, 5. Some change might be there. So it will be updated. Enlisting is very important because they have also a data set besides them. How many subscribers we have for DSAT? Till date, they have 17,500 users of this DSAT. This was the latest information by Dr. Jared Hugenboom, who is looking after all this. Who is actually the father of this DSAT presently. So better is not to copy paste, not to take the software from anywhere. Better is to you will get a link from them, download that link and install the software in your system.
Zoom meeting.
Yeah. Thanks, Jada sir. Okay, any other question, any other query? Because regression we have stopped tomorrow, Dr. Samira Kayum will take a lecture at 4 p.m. Oh. Is it okay for all? You can, all you can join with your cell phones, not required to join, because that will be a data set requirement of the mainly on the DSAT. So you can use your cell phones from anywhere. After that, once we start running DSAT, you have to be on your laptop or desktop so that it will be really in a virtual mode, right? Everybody okay with tomorrow's schedule?
Sir, can't it be after 4:30? Sir, because after 4, everybody will be in the office.
Yes, sir. Can it be after 4 o'clock, sir?
Can I pre-schedule it from 3:30?
Sir, yes, sir. It should be rescheduled after 4:30, sir. Please, sir.
No, pre-schedule. 4:30 is not
sir,
possible.
Sir, I am telling you, sir, because at that time it is university time. You very well know, sir, that.
Mustafa, sir, Dr. Samira, you know, she's very, very busy with his other assignments also. You know, she
is also late. Sir, my humble submission is then keep it at 3, sir. Because, sir, while moving at 4, everybody will be moving. So nobody will be able to listen to the lecture carefully in the cars.
Okay, I will try. I will talk to her. Let it be 3 or 3:30.
Dr. Bilal, I agree with Dr. Aziz. Because it will be a rush at that time. 4 is the, departure time. People leaving offices.
No, 4 is not the departure time. Actually,
no, 5, 4 is not the departure outside. Time, sir.
Outside, apart from our valley, outsiders, they have departure time 5:30, Ganjan?
Onward.
Sir, no, sir.
5:30 onward.
Sir, in our valley, we are having 2G only, sir. We have
I know that you have a 2G facility, but on mobile, you can easily join.
So that is why I am saying kindly schedule it for 3, sir. Kindly, sir.
Okay,
well,
I will request...
Well, Dr. Bilal, you can put request to Dr. Samira, keeping her busy schedule into consideration. If she agrees, then we'll let the participants
know. Yeah, sure.
I will ask her
to start at 3.
Thank you very much.
All the participants are okay with it. Tomorrow, sir, it can also be after 5:30,
like today, sir.
Madam is too much busy. Madam is 5:30 is not possible because she left the office at 5:30. It's a 2 traffic jam here. She reached the home at 7. While driving, she cannot deliver the lecture. That's why.
Well, you fix okay, sir, fix with her, okay. Time change and then let the participants know to the group.
Exactly, sir. Let us know through the WhatsApp. WhatsApp.
She will be okay.
I will talk to Dr. Samira Kishan regarding the
TV. Thank you, sir. Humbled, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
After that, we will start our DSAT program. Then overview, I will give, I think, myself, overview of DSAT. Then there will be a lecture on weather soil, file soil, crop management, etc., overview out, and then generation of results and sensitivity analysis. But before that, Dr. Shiraz.
Yes.
You need to have good evaluation, pre-evaluation, DSAT. Before starting the DSAT, already we have started the program. Before showing them running the program, we need to evaluate them. Have a 10 question. You please prepare the 10 questions on Google Form.
No issue.
Google Sheet and circulate in the group.
No issue.
And put some time frame. Let it be from 10 minutes or 15 minutes.
We'll be generating the link for those questions and then you accordingly share to the participants. I'll be developing them tonight.
Okay. Thanks a lot. Any other thing from participants?
Thanks a lot, sir.
Thanks a lot. Thanks, Mr.
Okay, thank you all.
Thanks all.
Thank you, sir. Okay. It was very nice talk, sir.
Thanks. Be ready with your laptops now. Okay, good night. Okay.
Okay, bye, sir.
Bye.